When they tie you from your village, you live a life that is on the same place. Look at your life, you are growing in age, but you are not growing in finances. Somebody might have tied your life in your village. That person might be a relative. But those relatives, listen, the devil uses people with the same DNA with you to bewitch you. That's why when I begin to pray for people just now,
is a threat to the kingdom of darkness.
a lot of orphans will also be blessed.
Take note that when you are delivered, the whole family will be delivered. Take note that when you are healed, you will spread the testimony about how Jesus
healed. They tell you in your village. In the city.
When you are tied in your village, a village atmosphere will come even in your city life.
Because I don't know to what drop yako, yaka yenga ni wani inch, Doraj. Village. Mukore unu, mutown, mwa munachile mutari ibo. Yembe zino petwa zoeswa mwumona, mwuma zino gara. You are in the city, but your life is the life of the village. I know I'm speaking to somebody. In this life, in this generation, someone here, for you to wear your nice shirt, you have to put them under a mattress for them to be ironed. That's why there's a lot of action in that bed. Are you ready to be taken to a city life? Are you ready to be taken to a city life? A better life in the city. There's a better life in the city. And that city that I brought this afternoon is Jesus Christ. That city that I brought you is the anointing of the Holy Ghost. When you are taken to that city called the anointing, you're asking people. I'm going to tell you to somebody right here. Take it from the village. Remember, in the village, are you still listening to me?
Oh, yes.
In the village, this donkey was on one area. In the village, this donkey had no progress. In the village, this donkey, there was no movement in their in its life. At that time, an anointed man like me was set to untie it. Says these two disciples, this donkey from the village, from a despised place. That's why God is coming to such a city like this. There are a lot of people that are saying, can anything good come?
such a place, one of the most prosperous people. You are coming out of such a place.
God, when He wants to use somebody, God, when He wants to raise you, He doesn't take you from the palace. He takes you from the village to the palace. I don't know who I'm prophesying this afternoon. I don't know who I'm preaching to this afternoon.
As you get into the city, whoever rejected you shall celebrate you. Whoever disappointed you, they shall appoint you.
So from the time this donkey was delivered from the village, the Bible says it was taken to Jerusalem, and Jesus was riding upon this donkey, and people began to celebrate. People began to ululate.
We have been delivered from your father's village. We have been untied from that village spirit. People who hated you begin to say, ah, we love you, sister. Ah, we love you, brother. Why? Because that smell of rejection has been removed from your life. When you are delivered from that village spirit,
that spirit that made you to be rejected, that spirit that brought rejection, will see you as you are in celebration. Who am I talking to this afternoon?
I came here as an anointed servant of Jehovah. Wherever you were rejected, you shall be accepted. Wherever you were disappointed, you shall be appointed.
So when it got to the city, Jesus sat upon the donkey, and the donkey was confused. People began to throw palm trees for the donkey to pass on. The donkey that was tied, it was able to walk on a red carpet.
That is what happens when you are delivered from the village. You begin to be exposed to certain platforms. You begin to be promoted where others are demoted. Of all the millions of donkeys in Israel, Jesus only needed one donkey for him to get to Jerusalem. And I'm prophesying to somebody here, of all the people in Korobra, of all the people in Kwazana, God is locating you and you and you, and you are about to receive your job. You are about to receive your miracle marriage. You are about to receive your miracle promotion.
When Jesus rode upon the donkey, he was waiting. Those who were speaking evil about the donkey stopped to entreat it because of the master who was sitting on the donkey. There is something that happens when Jesus sits over your life.
Some demons that were manipulating you will say, there is a master sitting in your life. We can no longer tamper with your marriage. We can no longer tamper with your health. We can no longer tamper with your finances. Why? Because
on your reception, the way you are accepted, the way you are received, is determined by who is sitting on you. As long as that feeling spirit is still sitting on you, no matter how much you try to find a job in Harare, but Jesus has got a plan this afternoon to sit over power life. And we're going to be celebrated. We're going to be accepted wherever we've been rejected. Then I told you this. So the donkey began to move on red carpets. People were ululating. People were whistling. People were celebrating.
see somebody marrying you today, it's not because of how beautiful you are, it is because of the Jesus sitting inside of you. When Jesus sits on you, you begin to earn respect that you don't deserve. That's why to some people here, I personally am 20 years younger than most people here. But you kneel down to say, Papa, it's not because of me, brother. Jesus is sitting on me. The anointing of the Holy Ghost is sitting on me. The power of the Spirit of God is seated upon me. And I see the same power coming upon you. Coming upon you, coming upon you. Lift up your head and show that I receive it. There's a time, and now is the time. You need to accept Jesus. You need to allow Jesus to sit upon you. When Jesus sits upon you, like what he is about to do this afternoon, on Monday, tomorrow, getting into that interview room, and the manager is sitting, and as you are getting inside that room, they are not seeing you, they are seeing the anointing of the power man in you. They are no longer seeing your educational qualification, they are seeing the power of the Holy Ghost over you. And I see that manager saying, where have you been? We have been waiting for you. We're waiting for you. Why? Because Jesus is sitting on you. When he sat on me, the time I was 50 years, even teachers who were teaching me, they began to see that this one is not a normal student. Teachers would come after school to the prayer line to be prayed for. Why? Because I was one type of a student who had Jesus sitting upon me. Am I talking to somebody already?
That coming will not yet an accident, because you shall be one of the passengers having Jesus sitting upon them. That family shall not die. Why? Because Jesus is seated in that family.
When you have Jesus seated upon you, the same business that you once tried and failed, go and try it again this time. I said, go and try it again this time. Am I prophesying to you?
I said, go and try it again this time. The same job that you tried to apply for, and they did not call you. Jesus is sending you back to that place.
So Jesus is seated on the donkey, and the people are celebrating. But the donkey must have a revelation. The donkey must have a revelation. Whoever sees people celebrating, they are not celebrating the donkey. They are celebrating Jesus who is seated on the
throne.
That's why no matter how much you may try to celebrate me as prophet is on, I am just a donkey which is being set on by Jesus. When people celebrate me, they are not celebrating me. They are celebrating the Jesus who is inside of me. Am I talking to somebody? So we're gonna remove that cord, that chain that connects you to your village. We are about to cut it right by the sword of the Spirit. And that sword is the word of God. Once you are delivered, we are going to introduce you to a new life, a city life.
a life of opportunities, a life of celebration, a life of elevation, a life of promotion,
a life of upliftment.
Are you ready for that life? Are you ready for that life? A lot of people here, you need to learn how to use fork and knife. Because in the city where we are taking you to, there are hotels, brother.
You shall die with kings. You shall eat with princes in the name of Jesus.
I remember years ago, being in a certain place with someone, I get to this place. Ordered expensive foods. And I said, brother in Christ, let's eat. The way he held the knife now, with the left hand as if he wanted to stab me. Then I knew this brother is in the city but behaves as if they are in the village. Listen, when God is about to elevate you to a city life, you need to upgrade your manners to city manners. If you are clapping, I'm not forcing you to clap. Look at your neighbor. Tell your neighbor. Upgrade yourself. Prepare yourself for the dimension that is about to be set ahead of you. Clap your hands for Jesus. There is a city life that I'm about to introduce to you. Hello, how are you? Are you ready for the city? You ready for the city life? I'm seeing a ticket written on you. It's written UAAAE, United Arab Emirates. It's something that you're gonna meet called Nyarai.
I receive.
And there's going to be a boutique that I'm seeing you getting involved into. Ministering to me that at your young age, you shall own shops, you shall own companies. Listen, one prophecy for one is a prophecy for all. And I prophesy to anybody in business, I say you shall also rise in business in Jesus' name. I'm about to come to you wherever you are. I'm going back to your village. Once I untie you, your life in the city shall shine. I say your life in the city shall shine. You shall rise above your enemies in the name of Jesus. Listen, we are not playing games here. I'm about to send the raw power of God. The raw power of Jesus is about to be sent wherever you are. In whatever name was written in any demonic calabash, I'm about to blot it out in the name of Jesus. Am I talking to you? You need to go deeper in prayer.
cancer, wherever your life has been tied from, I deliver you by fire in the name of Jesus. I set you free by fire in Jesus' name.
Are you ready to pray? I want to go back to your village. I want to break that clay pot.
That evil clay pot. Carrying your name, carrying the names of your family. I break it in the name of Jesus. I break it in the name of Jesus.
Switch your hands. What's this called? Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you ready to be set free?
Yes.
Are you ready to receive your deliverance? There is a time, and now is the time. I said there is a time, but now is the time. God is breaking you free. God is setting you free from that bloodline spirit. That spirit that was following you because of your cursed family is about to leave you. And we are about to take you into this blessed family. Take your own free space. Take a free space. Take a free space. Take a free space. Wherever you are, join me in prayer right now. So come to all of my houses. I'm looking for, even if I have two people, who are going to pray at another level. And I'm willing to release breakthroughs from those two people. Are you one of those two people? Are you one of those two people? You're going to forget about your neighbor. We want to push.
We want to pray until something moves in the realm of the spirit. There is a time we can pray and your debts can be canceled. There is a time we can pray until money will begin to fall down. There is a time we can pray until we suffocate that which we pray.
Lift up your legend of fire. Saying, God, untie me, deliver me, set me free. When we set you free, you can be married again. When you are set free, your business can rise again.